Welcome to the new session. So till now we have covered the post processing of EM parts. Now we'll know what are the guidelines to be followed for a process selection. Under that we'll be knowing why the process selection guidelines are important. In the introduction, selection of methods for parts and challenges of selection. So this is going to be covered in this session. Welcome to the new session, that is guidelines for additive manufacturing process selections, or in general we call it as the guidelines for process selection in AM process. As we know, additive manufacturing technology was mainly created for parts which are meant for visual and tactile communication. Means that is what we call that one as rapid prototyping technology. But down the line we have seen that the application of additive manufacturing process has expanded considerably, and from evolution we have seen that it has evolved in every set and directions of applications. AM process, like any other process, especially the material process or a mechanical engineering process, are having certain constraints. Constraints in the area of material properties, speed, cost and accuracy. Therefore, the performance capabilities of materials and machines is lagging way behind the conventional manufacturing technology. For example, the injection molding machinery and the CNC machining. Although this lag is decreasing day by day and there is increase in speed of manufacturing, and cost has reduced considerably in the material and the machine setup cost also. But in terms of market to time also, it has gained much appreciation, and AM technology is finding its contribution, or it is contributing a lot for particularly in complex and customized geometry production. So when we see such a vast advantages and applications of this AM technology or of additive manufacturing, there are certain issues which has to be taken into care. And if we follow some guidelines for the selection of the processes and selection of the machine and the product design features, then we can find much more effective and efficient AM manufacturing techniques or products in the market. Next question will come, why these guidelines are a necessity? Mainly for quotation support. So if a given part has to be developed or the product has to be manufactured using additive manufacturing, then we should know which machine and what material should I use to build, and that will help in preparing the quotation. How much the material cost will be there, how much the time will be consumed in running that machine. So the need of this quotation, for this quotation preparation, we should be knowing the process which are involved in each of the machining. Nextly, for making capital investment. So in capital investment support, we have to get to know what are the designs or how the design is and the industrial profile means what type of setup we are having, whether it is a small scale industry, medium scale industry or small enterprises, and what are the best machines in its class which can be procured and bought, and after buying those machines can it fulfill our requirements, means for the orders which are we are getting or the products which we are building and supplying, are it whether they are able to fulfill those requirements. So to enhance, to make use of this one, so what we should do, we have to have a good capital, and that capital has to have a break-even point also when we are going to earn the profit. For that also we should know the process of these machines. Next, as I have told you, the capital investment is required, then simultaneously we require to know the process planning and support. So in this we tell that if we do a better planning, half of our job is done. So what are the support structures which are to be taken into care when we are going to develop these products? So in the processes, so where they are going to hold, or which are the parts which have to be taken into care. So can a given part or a machine can do all the work in the much of its ability, or most efficient manner can it go ahead? So alongside, what are the other options which are existing in the task? Can it complete the whole task in the same process chain? So, or whether we require to have any additional supports in the form of logistics or in the form of warehouses, or we can give some task which are outsourceable. So these all things can also be known in this process planning support. So the guidelines for the process selection will help us to overcome these particular issues, or it will help in finding the answers for these questions. Now here comes the various guidelines for processing techniques which need to be focused in the case of a process selection of AM products. So the first one is the selection method for parts. Under this we are having different methods, that is, first one is the decision tree, second one is approaches to determine the feasibility, next approaches to selection, next selection by example. Next we are having the challenges of a selection after doing the selection of the parts. So we should know what are the challenges involved in selections. Then the process can be gone through some example system for a preliminary selection. So after knowing that we have to do this process, so we have to do some preliminary test on the selected process for that. Next, we have to go through production planning and control. Under that, we should know what are the pre-processings in the production line and what should be the post-processing works, and then a complete production plan after knowing the controlling aspects of this system. So these are the steps which has to be taken care, or these are the areas which has to be focused on the process techniques. Now we'll understand the first one, that is selection methods for parts. Under this we are having the decision tree. The decision tree is having a rich history. Basically it was evolved in the 1940s and 1950s from the field of economics. Although there are many approaches taken in decision tree field, But broadly, when we speak about the three elements in making any decision. So these are mainly used in making decision for a product or for a process or a material to bring into market from the management sides. So from there itself only these techniques have been borrowed. So the three elements for any decision making in a decision tree are: the first one is the options. This is going to tell the items from which the decision making or a decision maker is going to select. So options like we'll be having the options of time, cost and surface finish in case of additive manufacturing. We'll take an example and tell about that one. Then next comes the expectations of possible outcomes from these options. So what are the outcomes which are, whether the time is going to increase or decrease, cost increases or decreases, surface finish viable, good or not so good. So these are the outcomes which are going to come from these one. Those are the expectations. Then preferences. So after making the decision maker has to make a preferences. Means he has to grade them, value them, or he has to give weightage for the outcomes. So for low means a lower weightage of 0, high means good means a weightage of 1. So this will help in making the chart or a tree in which we can select which process is going to give the best product out of this one. Let's assume that a set of decision options are denoted by A 1 by 4th starts from A1, A2 till AN. So in an engineering application, one can think of outcomes as a performance. So they are the options which are to be measured by the set of evaluation criteria. So in engineering, what we do, we find which are the outcomes and those are categorized as they are the performers of this application. And what are the options? So for that, from those options, what we find the selection tool which has to be given the best out of these one. So more specifically, in coming to in our AM section, the outcome might be consisting of time of product development, cost involved and surface finish of the part which is getting built using any of the AM processes. While AM process itself is the option here. So here we can find out the process lines, means whether I am going to use the SLA process or whether I am going to use the FDM process or I am going to use SLS. So these are the options. Next comes the expectations of the outcomes, and they are to be modeled with a function. We are going to give the options with the functions like x 1 to the power g function of a, and can be modeled with the associated uncertainties. Means if they are not going to complete it, so there can be some uncertainties. Those also can be included into these expectations. Then comes the preference model. So the importance here given is what you are going to assign from the outcome. So decision maker is going to give some preference. So if it is coming at a very high time, so or it is taking a very less time, so that preference is going to rate it as 1 or good. If he is going to get it at a very low cost, he is going to rate it high. So he is going to give the preference model. In that he is going to do the assignment. So decision tree, for example, to tell here I have taken example. The designer may be preferring to have a low cost, short turn around times for the concept model, while being well to the accept that poor finish is also acceptable. But in many ad hoc decision support methods, preference are modeled with the help of weights. So we are going to give some weightage or importance, which are represented as scalars. So scalar quantity we are going to do. Typically, weights are specified to in such a manner that the sum of the weights are going to become 1, means it is going to start from point 1, point 2, point 3, and it is going till 1. A normalized curve we should get. For simple problems, the decision maker may just choose weights, while for more complex decision making, more sophisticated methods can be used, such as pairwise comparison. Means we can compare two techniques or two processes and have a weightage for the two techniques, or results of the two techniques can be checked on versus one versus another. Moreover, in decision tree, we have the utility theory. Here, preferences are modeled as utility functions on the expectations. So, expectations are then modeled as expected utility. The best alternative is one with the greatest expected utility. So, here, how much the utilization of the machine is taking place, or how much the full-fledged utilization of a product is coming from the machine which has been tasked. So if you are utilizing it completely, then we are going to rate it better. So that is also one of the thing which can think in decision. So this is like a selection of a player in a IPL match or in a cricket match. So whether we are going to utilize him completely, that is what. So under the selection problems, at the beginning it is addressed with the two related subprograms. First is, it is necessary to generate feasible alternatives in which of these cases we include the materials and processes also. In the second, we are going to find those feasible alternatives where a quantification process is applied that results in the rank order and a listing of alternatives. So which can be given the first preference, which is going to be given the second preference. So this can be ranked. The first subproblem is referred to as a determining feasibility. Just we are going to find out which is the best out of its class. So whether it is feasible or not in terms of cost and in terms of process. While second is simply called selection. So additional feasibility determination and selection method will be discussed in this section as well. So there we are going to tell more about how this feasibility or selection feasibility is going to work. Next is approaches to determine feasibility under selection methods for parts. So in selection of methods, we have told there are sub categories. In that, one is the determining the feasibility. So the problem of identifying suitable material for AM machines with which the fabricated parts is going to be created, surprisingly the complex parts. As noted previously, there are many possible applications for AM parts. So same AM part can be made using different techniques or on different machines. So in order to solve a AM machine and a process chain selection problems, one must able to navigate the wide varieties of materials. You should have that capabilities of finding out which material is suitable and machines, which machine can be utilized, and compare one's needs for their capabilities while making while ensuring that most up-to-date information is available with him, so that he can find out this decision-making tree viable for the product which is going to be developed. So important is updation and the data of information which should be available on two time. To date, we found that most approaches try to determine the feasibility by taking a tool that is called as a knowledge based approach. Here, in order to deal with the qualitative information related to M process we are able to get. This process quite helpful. One of the best developer who presented this one was Daglin and Bernard. This is called as a Daglin and Bernard method. So they presented a knowledge based system for generation, selection and process planning of a rapid manufacturing process. So it has been widely appreciated and many literatures tell that this is the one of the good approaches for determining a feasible solutions for a AM process. So what they did is the problem that they defined was to propose from a detailed functional specification different alternatives of a rapid manufacturing process which can be ordered and optimized when considering a combination of different specifications, like the criteria which were taken into consideration were cost, quality, detail or delay, aspect of materials, etc. This approach utilized two reason methods. One is case by case basis and another one is bottom up generation process. The strength of each was compensated for others' weakness. So this helped them to build a process plan. And this system was furthermost developed by Canvasser platform, and they utilized a relationship between a database system with extensive material, machine and application information. Then later a group of National University of Singapore, they developed an AM decision system that was integrated with the database also. Hence we find that a standard selection decision support problem, that is SDSP, has been applied in many engineering problems and have been recently applied in AM machine also to find the best way to complete the product approaches. Next, we'll take a scenario in which we do it by selection of example. So in this section, we'll represent an example of a capital investment decision related to application of AM process for the production of manufacturing a steel caster wheel. Here the illustration is of a production of steel caster wheel with the help of AM process. This selection problem is very similar to a quotation problem, but it includes a range of part dimension, not a single dimension values for one part. In this scenario, the caster wheel manufacturer is attempting to select an AM machine that can be used for production of its small custom order. It is infeasible to stock all the combination, means the wheels that we want to offer that has to have all the combination, but everything cannot be made feasible. Thus they need to be able to produce them quickly and keep the price down for the customers. That is the need. So from this need itself only you have to start to develop. The technologies which were under consideration for manufacturing this caster wheel are direct metal deposition, direct metal laser sintering, electron beam melting, laser engineered net shaping and selective laser melting and selective laser sintering. So before beginning out of the which to be selected, so the selection process started. The uncertainties involved in the customization process were also considered. Since these are caster wheels which has to be customized, there is a degree of a geometric uncertainties which is also involved. So important thing is the application of selection decision support method. As mentioned, it is very important to explore the several scenarios. So scenarios means a set of preferences available, like technologies available, process in available, and material available. So those are called as set of preferences. To understand and find the sensitivities of a rating and ranking for a change in preference. So these have to be ranked from 1 till 6 or 7, whatever ranking you require. And modification of methods are to be straightforward to achieve a target values. The target values here for this example to have the best geometry and to make it is at a low cost. So not only thinking of minimizing or maximizing an attribute, but to incorporate other types of uncertainties also. Uncertainties like tolerances, accuracies, all can also be incorporated. So this is what takes into consideration when we are going to selecting a method by a example. Next, after knowing the selection methods, selection by examples, the need is to know what are the challenges of selection. So in the previous example, or we have seen that the difficulties and the limitation of a straightforward application of decision methods to a real decision making situation. Nonetheless, with a proper understanding of different technologies and their attributes, because when we are having a complex geometries, complex parts, cost involving, so we have to find out what are the attributes which has to be related properly, and we have to net them properly so that we get the proper situation where we can optimize it. So how to relate them together and bring a meaningful information, that has to be gained. That is one of the biggest challenge in making decision. So let's see here. With the AM systems focusing slightly on different markets, for example, if there are large expensive machines, then they can fabricate the parts using variety of materials with a relatively good accuracy and having material properties with able to fine tune the system to meet the specific needs. Similarly, in contrast, we see that in a cheaper system which are designed to have a minimal setup and to produce a parts which are acceptable quality in a predictable and a reliable manner. In this, the later cases, parts not have a high accuracy, means the cheaper system will be not having a high accuracy, material strength or a feasibility of use. So they don't provide you the best of the material strength. So this is one of the challenge for a selection, which has to select, whether we have to select the expensive machine or the cheap system. Similarly, on the same lines, we can see different user will require different things from the same machine. Machines vary in terms of cost, size, range of materials which can be supplied, accuracy of the part, time to build, etc. So it is not surprising to know that most expensive machines provide the wide range of options for us. Therefore, it will be very important for someone like us in looking to buy a new machine, whether we are able to understand the cost versus its benefit. So it becomes very choosy. We have to become very choosy which best machine is suitable for our needs. So this is one of the challenges which has to be taken into consideration, or these are the challenges which has to be taken for making any decisions for for a selection of the process or the machines also. By this time, we know what are the challenges involved in a selection of a process. But when we are looking for advice, we need to find out suitable selection methods or a system. Then it will be very useful to consider the following part. That is, on a web-based systems which are developed to meet these considerations. So, to overcome the decision making very complex, so there are many systems getting developed. So here they provide the information in the system which is unbiased. So we should find out a system which is providing unbiased wherever it is possible. Then the method or a system should provide and advise rather than just get quantified results. Next, the method or a system should provide an introduction to AM to equip the user with the background knowledge as well as advice on different AM technologies. Then a range of options should be given to the user to adjust the requirement and show how changes in requirement can affect the decision. Then the system should be linked to comprehensive and up-to-date database of AM machines. Once the search process has completed, the system should give guidelines on where to look next for additional information. So using these steps, so we can overcome many of the challenges which we face in selection of a process. So these are put into a software or they are put into a knowledge based of the AM process, and they are being developed on a web pages also, for that easy accessible. Hence we can conclude that selection results depends on a large extent on a user's knowledge of what AM machine is capable of and its application. But expert advice or expert systems are attempting to avoid or to find out alternative that experts results from the extensive use of AM technology into a software package. So all the informations can be gathered into this one and can have assistance from these packages for a user in overcoming the at least some of the learning curves and quickly give in a single stage where most of its attributes or its options can be found out and best of the best practice can be implemented. Now we'll see through example system for a preliminary selection system. A preliminary selection tool was developed for a direct digital manufacturing, so a DDM process, and this preliminary selection tool is called as a DDMS, and the applications that the walks makes the user to walk through are a series of questions to be identified based on the feasibility and the process of the machines. Here it is going to tell about the build time and cost are computed for that building, but quantitative rating and rank ordering is not performed. More specifically, the software enables the designer, managers and service bureau personnel to mainly find out the AM technologies or explore AM technologies and their applications which are possible in the DDM project or on a digital direct manufacturing machine, and it will help in identifying the candidate materials and process, which material can be used and which process can be chosen in the DDM project, and it will help in exploring the build time, how much time it will take to build which are the build options, means a single layer or a double layer, which type of option it can be used, then cost involved in building that one, and it will help in exploring the manufacturing life cycle benefits of the EM. So how much time it will get this lifetime of this machine, what is the lifetime of the machine also it will be telling. Then select appropriate EM technologies for DDM applications. So which all applications have been using this DDM. Then explore the case studies, previous case studies, and anticipate their benefits, and mainly it will help in supporting in preparing quotation and capital investment decisions. So these preliminary selection tools or software are moreover helping in reducing the challenges. Okay. Next, the production planning control. The material covered in this section addresses the next type of selection decision introduced way before in the introduction. So we have introduced about this one in the introduction, namely the support for process planning, and it is probably most relevant to the activities of service bureaus, or we call it as SBs, which includes in the internal organization of any manufacturing companies that operate one or more EM processes. So the process planning is mainly related to the activities which are developed for the service bureaus. So considering the process, when a new part is to be presented to the service bureau for a building, in generally the informations are presented to the process planners, which will be including the following things, like first one, the part geometry, next number of parts to be developed, then delivery date or schedule for batches of the parts, then process other than AM to be carried out, like pre-processing and post-processing, and what are the expectations of the user, like accuracy, degree of finish, etc. Furnished with all this small amount of data, it is possible to start integrating with the new job with the existing jobs which are running on the machines and with the available resources. Four topics will be explored here in this production planning and control, namely the production planning, pre-processing, part building, and post-processing. Now let's see the pre-processing. So as we know, pre-processing means a software based manipulation. So this will be carried out on a file that describes the geometry of the part. Such manipulation can generally be divided into two areas, that is modification of design, which may be required, and determination of build parameters. Under modification of design may be required, we have two reasons for that one to do. The first one is we need to find out whether the part details are to be needed to do any adjustment or to accommodate the process characteristics, like for example their tolerances, size, fits, all those things has to be accommodated in this one in the file itself only. Then second models can may require some type of repair work in the STL file or IGS file or the STL file. These files may be having some problems, such as missing of triangulars or triangles, or incorrect orientation of the surfaces, or likewise. So these modification design require pre-processing works. Next one is determination of build parameters. So this is very important, and this is very specific for a AM process of each which one we are going to be using. This includes selection of part orientation, then support generation, setting of build styles, and layer thickness selection, and what temperature it has to work, or setting the working temperature, filament temperature, or the exposure temperatures. So under these circumstances, the user must devote more time and attention to the parameters settings. So, hence, the decision support software should make sure that the process planner is aware under which circumstances they are going to get exposed or what is working, and may occur and allocate a quite healthy resources appropriately, which can be used for completing the task. Next is part build. For some processes like FDM and lens technology, it does not really matter in terms of time whether the parts are built in one layer or another, one after the another, or in batches. Parts are grouped together in batches, so it is quite seen there. But however, most processes will vary significantly regarding this factor, mainly because of the temperature issues or building up of layers and orientation. Another important factor is the part orientation. It is well known that because of anisotropic properties caused by most of the AM process, parts will generally build more effectively and in one orientation compared with another. For those machines that need to use support structures during the build process, this represents an additional problem, both in terms of build time, allocation of the time to build the support structures, and for a different orientation. And also it takes more post-processing time, that is removal of the supports. So we have seen that many researchers have discussed all these dilemmas. What is this generally means is a process planner has to make a compromise. A compromise is not usually to a process planner. In fact, it is a typical character. But a degree of feasibility produced by many AM machines make this a particularly interesting problem. Just because we have a AM machine, it is not which is being constantly used, does not mean that it is being quite efficient or effective. So while doing the part building, so these all things have to be taken into consideration. How we are going to make the part get deposited layer by layer. Next is the post-processing work. So after the build is complete, all AM parts require some degree of post-processing, that is removal of the support material. So at a low end, this may require just a removal of a support structure or a removal of excess powder for those who merely want quick simple verification. But at a higher end, the AM process may be very insignificant with the time overhead in the overall process. Parts may require a large amount of skilled manual work in terms of surface preparation and coating. Alternatively, the AM parts may be one stage in a complex rapid tooling process that requires numerous manual and automated stages. All this can result from some source machine, and it can even be an iterative process involving all the steps at different stages in the development based on the same part of the CAD data. Okay. So let us summarize what we have understood or studied in this session. So we got to know why these guidelines have to be followed for a process selection in a AM process. So the various methods are, first one is selection methods for parts, under that the decision tree, then approaches to determining feasibility or feasibility, approaches for a selection to make a proper selection, then selection by examples, then what are the challenges faced while selection, then example of a system for making a preliminary selection, then after production what has to be done in case of making the part completion like pre-processing, part building and post-processing works. So this completes the session of guidelines for process selection. Thank you. You can contact me through my email ID, that is naveen.kalal@canraengineering.in.